Just one announcement. After Mass today, please stop by the Mass Ministry Showcase tables located in the gathering space and in the Monongalia entrance to learn more about the many opportunities available to you to serve our area faith community through the various ministries needed here during Mass. Individuals are on hand to answer questions you may have about Mass ministries or to assist you in signing up to be part of the team. Would you be able to give of your time in this very important endeavor? God has gathered us together to renew our efforts in sharing the life of Christ and being the love of Christ. So please stand, greet the presence of Christ in one another, introduce yourself to those you may not know. Please join in singing with us number 302 in the Maroon Pew Hymnal, or on the screens in front of you, number 302, Gather Us In.
Son and of the Holy Spirit. The Lord be with you. Good evening, everyone. We gather around God's table. It is here that we join with the publican in today's gospel, acknowledging, Lord, be merciful to us who are sinners. It is here that we come then to embrace and to receive the gift of God's forgiveness, the gift of his mercy. So as we begin this liturgy, let us call to mind those times when we have failed to be humble in our thoughts, words, and actions. Lord Jesus, you are bread for those who hunger. Lord, have mercy. Christ Jesus, you are healing for all who are sick. Christ, have mercy. Lord Jesus, you are forgiveness for the sinner. Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us all our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth is a people of good will.
Let us pray. Almighty, ever-living God, increase our faith, hope, and charity, and make us love what you command, so that we may merit what you promise. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Serves God willingly is heard. His petition reaches the heavens. The prayer of the lowly pierces the clouds. It does not rest till it reaches its goal, nor will it withdraw till the Most High responds, judges justly, and affirms the right. And the Lord will not delay. The word of the Lord.
Proclaim your greatness, O the second letter of St. Paul to Timothy. Beloved, I am already being poured out like a libation, and the time of my departure is at hand. I have competed well. I have finished the race. I have kept the faith. From now on, the crown of righteousness awaits me, which the Lord, the just judge, will award to me on that day, and not only to me, but to all who have longed for his appearance. At my first defense, no one appeared on my behalf, but everyone deserted me. May it not be held against them. But the Lord stood by me and gave me strength, so that through me the proclamation might be completed and all the Gentiles might hear it. And I was rescued from the lion's mouth. The Lord will rescue me from every evil threat and will bring me safe to his heavenly kingdom. To him be glory forever and ever. Amen. The word of the Lord.
Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke. Jesus addressed this parable to those who were convinced of their own righteousness and despised everyone else. Two people went up to the temple area to pray. One was a Pharisee and the other was a tax collector. The Pharisee took up his position and spoke this prayer to himself. O God, I thank you that I am not like the rest of humanity, greedy, dishonest, adulterous, or even like this tax collector. I fast twice a week and I pay tithes on my whole income. But the tax collector stood off at a distance and would not even raise his eyes to heaven, but beat his breast and prayed, O God, be merciful to me, a sinner. I tell you, the latter went home justified, not the former. For whoever exalts themselves will be humbled, and the one who humbles themselves will be exalted. The Gospel of the Lord. Thank you. If you're over the age of 20, why, you're certainly familiar with the song whose lyrics go, "O Lord, it's hard to be humble when you're perfect in every way." Ah, yes, those of us that are old enough remember the song. Perhaps we sang it once or twice. It is hard to be humble when you're perfect in every way, but I would contend, why, perfection perhaps doesn't have anything to do with it. Yes, it's hard to be humble when you're perfect, and yet we realize none of us here today is perfect, but it's still hard to be humble, even when perfection is not part of the equation. It's hard to be humble in a society and a culture in which we live today that prides itself on uniqueness. It's hard to be humble when we live in a culture and a society that provides or prides itself on being different, on being set apart, on being, well, just on being different and number one. It's hard to be humble when there seems to be such an emphasis on having something that nobody else has. We all realize the whole reality of supply and demand, and the less of the supply and the greater the demand, why, then what happens? The price goes up. Yes, there's something about having something that nobody else has that is something that people want to have. Why, there's something about having something that nobody has that enables you and I then to be unique. It enables you and I to be different, and sometimes it can also enable you and I to be rich in material wealth. It's just plain difficult to be humble. And yet today's gospel invites you and I to take the stance of the tax collector. Jesus wants you and I to realize that humility is at the heart. It needs to be at the foundation. It needs to be where we begin. Humility, based upon the conviction that as much as we are unique, and as much as we are different one from the other, we all share in a common humanity. And the gospel today reminds us that we not only share in a common humanity, but we share in a common sinful humanity. For the prayer of the tax collector is certainly our prayer. Will God be merciful to me, a sinner? It's the very first thing, it's the very first way in which Pope Francis identified himself in an interview a couple of years ago as he began his pontificate, when asked by the person interviewing him, how would you identify and define yourself? And what did Pope Francis say? The very first words out of his mouth were this: I am a sinner. I am a sinner. Indeed, Francis understood and understands that once we begin there, why, then we recognize and we acknowledge that need for an inner transformation that takes place, and that we can't provide it, but rather it needs to be provided for us. It needs to come from our origin. It needs to come from our source. It needs to come from God himself. So the tax collector stands at a distance and utters a simple prayer. And yet there's the Pharisee in each and every one of us, because we recognize our own uniqueness and our own differences one from the other. And so it's hard, isn't it, to live our lives each and every day without somehow comparing and contrasting ourselves with others. Thank God I don't think like they do. Thank God I don't look like they do. Thank God I don't have what they have, that disease or infirmity. Thank God, why, we're constantly thanking God because, well, that we're not like the rest of humanity, that we're not like them, that we're not like those people. that we're not like that mindset. You and I are constantly, each and every day, allowing the Pharisee within us to have its moment, to have its day. You and I are always comparing and contrasting ourselves to one another. And while that in and of itself is not necessarily sinful, it certainly is human. But where it becomes sinful is where we find ourselves being better, or being superior, or being above the rest. Because the reality, my friends, is this: none of us will escape the two realities of being born into the world and also experiencing death in this life. For those are the two things, being born and dying, that are common to each and every one of us. The other thing that is common, of course, is our sinful state, that not only are we redeemed by Christ and his life and love, we are also given the grace that is necessary to overcome our sinful reality. We come today recognizing that as human beings, we share so much in common, that rather than trying to be different, trying to stand out to the crowd, trying to be better than others, you and I are invited to embrace our common humanity. And our common humanity is grounded in the God who gives us life. Our common humanity is grounded in the God who bestows upon us mercy. Our common humanity celebrates the fact, as we heard in today's first reading, that God shows no partial, that he has no favorites. He hears the cries of the poor. He listens to all of our prayers. He hears us no matter what the color of our skin, no matter the values that we hold, no matter the sins that we have committed, no matter the financial wealth we might have or the titles we might hold. God hears all of us. He loves all of us. But in order for you and I to believe that, why, we must recognize our common reality and our common prayer. Oh God, be merciful to us, sinners. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us, for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate to the Virgin Mary, and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Let us come to the Lord our God, who is mercy, who is our help, as we offer to him this day our prayers.
For the church and for members of all faith traditions, that we welcome those who seek God's mercy and compassion, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our national elections, that those who are elected will lead with a concern for all and bring healing to divisions in our country, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the wisdom and understanding to believe that God sees all people with the same love, attention, and care, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all families, that growing in holiness, they show kindness and mercy to each other and to all they meet each day by sharing the life of Christ and being the love of Christ, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the sick and dying, and for those who have died, remembering today Claire Mertens, Eugene Strauss, Vernon, Yvonne, and Scott Koffenberg, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the prayers we hold in our hearts that we offer up today, and for the safety of all travelers, hunters, and farmers during this harvest and hunting season, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer. Almighty, eternal God, we call upon you today as we do each and every day. Hear us as we pray. Answer our petitions according to your will, for we ask them through Christ our Lord. Invite our children to bring their offerings forward.
Please join in singing with us number 605, I Want to Walk as a Child of the Light, number 605 in the Maroon Pew Hymnal or on the screens in front.
I want to walk as a child of the light.
pray, sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Look, we pray, O Lord, on the offerings we make to your majesty, that whatever is done by us in your service may be directed above all to your glory. Through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For you laid the foundations of the world and have arranged the changing of times and seasons. You formed us in your own image and set humanity over the whole world in all its wonder. To rule in your name over all you have made and forever praise you in your mighty words. And so with all the angels we praise you as in joyful celebration we acclaim. You are indeed holy, to be glorified, O God, to love the human race, and to always walk with us on the journey of life. Blessed indeed is your Son, present in our midst when we are gathered by his love. And when, as once for the disciples, so now for us, he opens the scriptures and breaks the bread. Therefore, Father most merciful, we ask that you send forth your Holy Spirit to sanctify these gifts of bread and wine, that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. On the day before he was to suffer, on the night of the Last Supper, he took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, gave you thanks, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again, until
Therefore, Holy Father, as we celebrate the memorial of Christ, your Son, our Savior, whom you led through his passion and death on the cross to the glory of the resurrection, and to whom you have seated at your right hand, we proclaim the work of your love until he comes again, and we offer you the bread of life and the chalice of blessing. Look with favor upon the oblation of your church in which we show forth the paschal sacrifice of Christ that has been handed on to us, and grant that by the power of the Spirit of your love, we may be counted now until the day of eternity among the members of your Son, in whose body and blood we have communion. And so, having called us to your table, Lord, confirm us in unity so that together with Francis, our Pope, and John, our Bishop, with all bishops, priests, and deacons in your entire people, as we walk your ways with faith and hope, we may strive to bring joy and trust into the world. Remember our sisters and our brothers who have fallen asleep in the peace of your Christ, and all the dead whose faith you alone have known. Admit them to rejoice in the light of your face and in the resurrection give them the fullness of life. Grant also to us, when our earthly pilgrimage is done, that we may come to an eternal dwelling place and live with you forever, there in communion with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the apostles and martyrs, and with all the saints. We shall praise and exalt you through Jesus Christ, your Son. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. Together we pray as Jesus taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ, for the kingdom. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. And the peace of the Lord be with you always." Let us offer to each other a sign of peace. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those now called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be. us pray. May your sacraments, O Lord, we pray, perfect in us what lies within them, that what we now celebrate in signs we may one day possess in truth, through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. As Tim mentioned at the beginning of Mass, this weekend and next weekend, we're highlighting the various ministries that take place here every time we gather to celebrate the Mass on the weekends. As you know, it takes many people and it takes many different types of ministries to make sure that our worship happens here at the Church of St. Mary each and every weekend. We are in need of extra people, new people in every one of the ministries that are part of our Mass, but we are in particular in need of three specific ministries that I'd just like to highlight this evening. The first is here at our Saturday evening Mass, we are especially in need of more sacristans. These are the men and women who get everything set up for Mass before Mass, and of course then take the opportunity to clean up everything after Mass. And so again, there's training for all of our ministries, but we are especially in need of sacristans. We are also in need of ushers here on Saturday evening Mass. And so again, you don't have to be a man, and you don't have to be in your middle ages to be an usher. So you can be women, you can be families. Again, we encourage all types of individuals to serve in that capacity. And thirdly, we are also desperately in need of people to assist with the audio and the video technology that we now have with the advancement of slides, and so that we can enjoy, of course, the words in front of us to be able to sing and to participate in Mass. So if any of those interest you or any of the other ministries, please take a moment. We have brochures in the back that help define these ministries. Again, please be assured that we will provide you adequate training so that you feel prepared to be able to do these ministries. Without you, of course, we cannot make our celebration of the Mass happen each and every weekend. Lastly, please join with me in thanking the Handbell Choir for leading us in our music tonight. Our Mass is now ended. Let us go in peace to love and to serve the Lord.
Let us go forth singing number 423, I Sing the Mighty Power of God, number 423.